Hey guys, welcome to my channel. It's your girl Get Mo Fit, and today I'm getting a massage, a much needed massage. It's a rest day for me, so I'm gonna bring you guys along with me so you can see how it goes down. I have my girl Tina right here, my massage therapist. She will be doing my massage. Tina, go ahead and give them your business information.
So you can actually find me on Instagram at butterfly_sky, which is SKIYH. Or you can simply go to my website, which is dmrt.glossgenius. That's GLOSSGENIUS.com.
So if you are in the Maryland area, the Bowie area specifically, I don't live in Bowie, but I travel to come see her because her hands is like that. They are blessed, guys. And I don't know about y'all, but I don't want nothing but blessed hands touching me. But I want you guys to come on this journey today with me, and I want you guys to check it out. And I hope you guys enjoy this as much as I'm about to enjoy this. Let's get it. All right, guys, I'm about to change.
So I'll go ahead and explain what it is that I'm doing now. When pressing into the glute, simultaneously going up the erector spinae allows for additional release in that lower back. Because 80% of lower back tightness comes from the glutes. So right now I'm applying pressure to get into the subscapularis, which sits under the trapezius, is deep and causes a lot of problems in a lot of people with shoulder shrugging. And it hurts. So Mo has shoulder issues where she sometimes will subluxate, meaning that she will separate from the humeral joint. I tend to not really loosen it up too much because I want her to continue to maintain tension whenever she goes and does her crazy workouts. But today she said it's bothering her. So I'm gonna go into a few points that is gonna help to release not really the tension, but more so the pain relief. And this is one of those spots right here. It hurts. So this is infraspinatus. Sits right on top of the shoulder blade. And it's a part of the sits muscles, which are the muscles that control your shoulder. They're called the shoulder girdle muscles. All those lat pull downs get stuck. So the shoulder's not able to rotate once this serratus gets stuck. I don't know if you can see it, but you'll see that she's having a lot of trigger point release throughout, where you'll see the muscle flicker. And that is because everything is referred. So where she's feeling an issue is not necessarily within that spot. It's all over because she's firing all over her shoulder right now. to whenever you see me just reach a point where I sit, it's because there's a blockage and I need for it to release so that the blood flow can get back to normal. And typically when you have a blockage in the muscle, it creates a rippling effect where it starts to pull on everything else. That's creating tightness. Then you'll stretch, you'll get a massage, but then you'll still feel like nothing has been, you know, loosened up, and that's because you still have a blockage somewhere within the muscle that needs to be released. So I typically leave no stone unturned. Also, this is where a lot of carpal tunnel originates. Not in the wrist. You can also tell that she has shoulder issues because you can see she's winged out more and rotated internally, and then she's not as winged on this side. She's more tight on this side, especially on her lat pull down, because with the shoulder issue she's having here, she's offsetting. So the body is tilting in a certain way to where she's pulling more on her lat from her left side than her right. I don't have to go underneath with the elbow on this side because of the rotation she has, so it's more exposed. And typically I would go in and address all of the trigger points, but like I said, I wanted to leave some tension within her shoulders. Everyone knows that Mo is a runner, and she experiences the low back pain, like I was saying, from the glutes, and her glutes are super tight. So I'm gonna stay here for just a little bit. And it's always good to work the muscle from all different angles because the fibers go different ways. So now from this angle, I'm going to address some of her iliopsoas, which is part of the runner's muscle. It runs here and it helps to rotate and drive forward. And when that gets tight, it shortens you. And it also causes pain in the back. So now I'm getting ready to address her favorite part.
Oh God.
Which are the adductor muscles. Another important area I like to address is the popliteus. Many therapists in school were taught not to address this area because of the popliteal artery. But I find that this area is important because this is the muscle that controls the locking out of the knee. And there tends to be blockages that get here. And that's how the PCL, the meniscus, and the ACL end up being torn. Or when you have knee pain and you don't know where it's coming from, typically this muscle back here needs to be released.
Okay.
Anybody with plantar fasciitis? It does not start in the foot. It's all in the calf. You address the calf, you'll address the plantar fasciitis issue in the foot.
I feel good. It hurt, but I feel good. I feel great. Whew. All right, y'all. We just finished, and I feel like a brand new person. I forgot to tell you guys in the beginning, I got a sports therapeutic massage. This massage, I'm not going to say the whole thing hurts. There are places where it hurts because I'm very tight in certain areas. As you guys learned, I have a plethora of injuries from shoulder dislocations to nerve damage. I got a lot going on. So my muscles tighten up a lot. I do my mobility work. I do my stretching. Sometimes I fall short, and when it does, my body tenses up. And that's why I come to Tina, because Tina releases all that. So as we go through certain areas, it hurts, but as she releases, like right now, I feel great. Like I feel loose. I feel like I could go and bust out all my little crazy moves all over again right now, but I'm not gonna do that because my body needs to recover. And that's the whole point of this massage. Again, you guys have her information from the beginning. I'll put it down in the caption so you guys can see. You guys hit her up. Or if you know you're not local, find somebody in your area that can do it. For me personally, when it comes to my sports massages, I do not want to be falling asleep during those massages. I want to feel you loosening me up. And I have been to like so many places where that just didn't happen. It was like, it was a nice relaxing thing, but it really didn't do the job that I needed it to do. I'm an athlete. I need to be able to perform. So I need those muscles loose. And so that means I need a good person on my body. Even when I'm whining and pouting through, they gonna do what they gotta do. And my girl Tina did that for me. I feel so good, y'all. I feel so good. But again, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video. Follow me on Instagram, GetMoFit, GET_MOEFIT. And follow me on TikTok, okay, guys? Thanks. I'll see y'all later.